And good evening. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The announcement came this morning that Kestrel Aircraft would open its new manufacturing facility in Wisconsin instead of here in Maine as originally thought. It was just about a year and a half ago that Kestrel said it hoped to bring the jobs to Maine as part of the redevelopment of the old naval base in Brunswick. Tonight, there are questions about what went wrong here in Maine and why Wisconsin won out. News 8's Norm Karkos is live in Brunswick with our Project Economy coverage. Norm?
Hi there, Tracy, and good evening to you here from Brunswick, where Alan Klapmeyer, the CEO of Kestrel, telling me today that he was emotionally attached here to the city of Brunswick, Maine, but he had to make a very quick financial decision based on what was best for his company. Now, while many people who are associated here with Brunswick are very disappointed with the decision, they know it wasn't for a lack of trying.
This time last year, the mood was upbeat in Brunswick. Kestrel Aircraft was looking to add up to 300 jobs to the region. Today, a different mood. Those jobs are now heading to Wisconsin.
Sad, yes. I'm sad that we got a double up, didn't get a triple or a home run, absolutely. But we're still here. Kestrel will still have a presence here.
Kestrel will still keep up to two dozen jobs in Brunswick, but the city had its eyes on the larger prize. Alan Klapmeyer, the CEO of Kestrel, says he proposed a package of his company's needs to Brunswick in July of 2010 and says as of last September, it was still missing some pieces. Klapmeyer says he had other offers on the table and had to make a decision soon. Superior, Wisconsin, an area where Klapmeyer has ties, won out with incentives including a low interest loan for nearly $2.5 million and a $500,000 loan from Douglas County, Wisconsin. But the real selling point was Wisconsin financing $20 million for a federal tax credit. The Midcoast Regional Redevelopment Authority worked with the state of Maine to try to finance the tax credit, but could not in time.
We've brought everything to the table for this company, and we can hold our head up high that everything was on the table. We came back to the table, and we looked for additional solutions for them, and we feel that we still have those solutions.
Those in Brunswick say it is a setback, but not all is lost.
When they first said they were going to close down the base, all I ever heard of was tumbleweeds and a cloud. Mm-hmm. So far, we have 17 new companies out at the base.
Meanwhile, Steve Levesque, the executive director of the Redevelopment Authority, telling News 8 today in a statement, quote, "We are greatly disappointed by the decision, but they look forward to working with Kestrel to support their growth here in the state of Maine as well." Here in Brunswick, Norm Karkos for News 8.